Hey everyone, welcome to the third video of this series. In this video, we're going to explore how to create intensity brushes, add texture, and sub-brushes to brushes using Affinity Photo. So, let's get started. To create an intensity brush, we need a nozzle, which is a black and white PNG image with a transparent background. So, let's create one. I will open this ink droplets image in Affinity Photo. Then, using the selection tool, select some of the droplets of different sizes. After selecting, press Ctrl plus C to copy the selection. Then go to File and click on New from Clipboard. A new file from the selection will be created. I will scale it down a little bit. This lower right side corner looks blank, so I will copy and paste a droplet from the image here. Next, I will group and rasterize these two layers into one layer. Add an HSL adjustment layer and decrease the saturation to make it black and white. Also, add a levels adjustment and increase the black levels and decrease the white levels. Export this image in PNG format. Now, open the brush menu from the brush panel and click on New Intensity Brush. Select the PNG image exported earlier from the File Explorer. The intensity brush is created. The main difference between an image brush and an intensity brush is that you can change the brush color of the intensity brush. I will edit the general and dynamic brush settings according to my liking. Feel free to experiment with the settings to achieve your desired brush. Let's head over to the texture tab of the brush settings. Here you can add more brush nozzles and textures to brushes. To add another brush nozzle, click on the Add button and select another PNG black and white image with a transparent background. Set the pressure controller according to your need. By default, it is set to random. Click on the Remove button to remove the nozzle. Let's add textures to this round brush. Click on Edit Brush, then go to the Texture tab. Here, click on the Set Texture button and select the texture from the File Explorer. Try to add a seamless texture for best results. I will add this seamless texture downloaded from FreePick. You can find the link in the description. You can see in the texture thumbnail. The texture becomes black and white and looks a little faded. And when I draw using this brush, there is this background which is not that great looking. To fix this, let's edit our texture. Like the nozzle, the texture should be a black and white PNG. We'll make the background transparent for best results. So, open the texture in Affinity Photo, then make the background transparent using blending options. Next, using HSL adjustment and levels adjustment, make it black and white. Export this texture as a PNG image. Let's add this PNG as a texture to our round brush. Using the scale slider, we can scale up and down the texture for the brush. Using this invert option, we can invert the colors of our texture. Let's explore the sub-brushes section in the brush editing tab. I will create a new intensity brush with another nozzle and tweak the general and jitter settings. In the sub-brushes, we can add either a round sub-brush or a bitmap sub-brush. First, I will add a round sub-brush. You can also tweak the sub-brush settings like brush settings. Next, let's add a bitmap sub-brush and edit the settings. Add scatter in the X and Y axis for best results. It looks something like this. Let's create an intensity brush with both texture and sub-brush and see how it looks. Nice, looks interesting. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more tutorials and tips. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.